Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the ListView component header, item and its group header using templates. Here I'm going to continue with my existing example of Blazor ListView. If you want to know how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add Syncfusion Blazor ListView component to it, please refer to the video link shown in the above card and also in the description below. First, I'll open the example where the ListView component is configured to load call list data using its data source property. To this data source, I have already defined a model class contact details with the fields like ID, text, picture, avatar, and category. The data source fields text and ID are mapped to the ListView component properties within the ListView field settings tag. I will explain the usage of other fields later in this video. Now I will run this example. Look at the output. The ListView component is rendered with the contact details. Next, I'm going to show you how to customize the header using the header template property. To customize the header in my application, I need to show the header by including showHeader property and setting its value to true. Then I add the ListView templates tag to specify the custom template and include the tValue property to specify the data model of the template content. Then I add the header template tag and span tag as the container for my custom string and add the call history string. I also add icon to the header by defining the custom font and use its CSS class name in another span element. See the output. The ListView is rendered with the header text with custom icon. Let me show you how to customize ListView items using the template property. Here you can see the built-in CSS classes like eListTemplate, eListWrapper, eListAvatar and so on are used to customize the list items. Now I will show you how to include avatars or images to the right side of the list item text in the ListView component. I include the template property and add a div element that acts as a wrapper to the template element. To this div element, I add the mandatory class eListWrapper to differentiate a template rendering from normal rendering. Then I add the eListAvatar class to customize the avatar in the list items. All these classes should be added to the template element wrapper to customize list items. You can see the list items here. Avatar field of a few items is an empty string. So I will render the list items based on the avatar and pick fields. Now I write a condition which checks if the list item has an avatar, then I show the avatar inside the span element with a built-in classes like eAvatar and eAvatarCircle. These two classes are added to display a circular avatar. Also, I customize the background of this avatar by adding a few CSS styles. I add background property to the CSS class and use it in the span element. If the avatar field in the list item is empty, then I add images using the image element with help of the CSS class. I add background image property to the CSS class and use it in the image element class. Then I add the span element and define the text field. Look at the output page now. The list view items have avatars or images added to the right side of the list item text. Finally, I will show you how to customize the group header in my application using the group template property. To do this, I group the list view items based on the category field from contact details class. So, the category of each list item should be mapped with the group by field of the data. See the output now. The call history is grouped based on the category. To customize the group header, I add the group template property. I set the string day to the span element along with group header text. See the output. The group header is displayed with the text day. Let me quickly summarize what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to customize the header, item and its group header using the template property. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also grab your chance of getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for a community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.